So my project is called Centra.
I'm so taken by that vacuum.
A little bit about me. I started in the engineering program here with technical drawing my freshman year. So far, I've obtained of my CSWP followers. I was planning on getting my CSWPA, but I didn't have time for that this year. And I'll be attending the Colorado School of Mines this fall. We'll start off with advisors, and my first expert advisor is Noah Yo. He has vast knowledge in math and science, and he's a staff software engineer at a financial tech firm. Richard Kim, he doesn't have a picture, but he graduated from the School of Mines with a master's in account engineering, a bachelor's in business engineering, and a minor in bioengineering and life sciences. And he's currently a technical sales engineer at Rainbow Research Office. And on to my support members, I have Tyler Chakamoto, who's a good friend. He has a CSWP followers, so he helps with a lot of the software followers aspects in the newer project. And Sarah Warnock, she's a good friend as well, and she's also adept in software. I have this Mitchell, who I don't think is here right now, but she's a teacher here at ANU, and she's there for my moral support to keep on track of my projects. And I also have Ivan, who's also a student here, and he's very young and pro-family. So, how many of you guys have seen that tour as a kid? Yeah. So, we're basically taking that idea. And I'm showing you a video of where I got my inspiration. I don't think there's down there. This project is called the Inform Display. So they basically take a bunch of pins, use my actuator, and they have this sensors from like the Kinect Wii thing, I think, and the Xbox Kinect, and they use those sensors to have like a real-time view of those the objects under the sensor. They only use sensors, and for my project, I wanted to use a CAD program such as SOLIDWORKS and have the object made on that software and be, have it be represented on the shape display. And so I wanted to make this for CAD because 3D printing takes like 10 hours just to print out a small object, and so I just wanted a quick and efficient way to have a visual aid for students that like interacting. So expect your research. I'm not that skilled in programming. I'm like fairly new at this, so I've had to research a lot of programming, and for this project, I had to research how to change the position of the actuators, and had to use their SOLIDWORKS APIs, which is basically the interaction of SOLIDWORKS with the program that you use to control the actuator's position. And so the final outcomes for today are for a working shape display that will be, and that I'd be able to use at least control the position of at least one pin and have the vast understanding of the SOLIDWORKS API. So my objectives were once again, having an understanding of APIs, learning programming language, and Erin Ellis once used a PA, but I was not able to achieve that. Developing programs that can manipulate the user experience, and build confidence in presentations like that. So for my logo, quick shout out to Nitty, I don't think she's here, but she helped me make this. So the idea was to have two hands touching each other, one hand representing the digital side of my project, so taking the object and solvers, and then the right hand side is representing the life and the human interaction between the data and the shape display. So my timeline, that was my plan, timeline right there. But what actually happened was it was all smooth here, just researching a bunch and catching up on what I should do. And then I keep going to November and trying to find material for the my project and here writing the code and then having a job show. In summer, we had half the month for a break, so I didn't do much except for the job shadow, and I wasn't able to get the materials for the display yet because I still was researching that. In January, I began researching APIs since I wasn't able to get the pins ready and the material for the assembly. February, I began working on the code and working with the APIs and the solvers. And then in March, I worked on programming the active resolution and then finally assembling the display. And this month, we worked on the actuator and the API. I wasn't able to integrate the two together because I wasn't. I didn't have enough time, and so I have the visual aid, but that's where I'm going to and presentations. So my research included, I didn't know how to start off the project, so money was a key issue in this project because the sheet display that MIT used, I totaled it out to be like a little more than $10,000. I don't have that kind of money, so I had to decide if I wanted an actual full shape display or just one that represents a theoretical part of the whole project. So I had to research what kind of actuators I might use. Pneumatic, which is, uses air, are fast and low cost, but they're not efficient in controlling the position. And Electric actuators are more expensive, but they you're allowed to manipulate the positioning of the actuators more easily. And so I decided to go on with using an electric actuator and just having one pin to represent the code that I have. And so controlling the actuator, we had to use a loop. And then so we compared the value of the potential medium used from the actuator and then compares it to the value you actually want, and it keeps going around until it matches up. This is some of the code for controlling the actuator. So I had to research API. So an API is basically integrating two different programs to work together. Like, you know how on Facebook you can see the Instagram photos on Facebook, so that's kind of the same idea. And so I wanted to use the SOLIDWORKS API and integrate it with my program to control the actuators. And SOLIDWORKS, they have an API for utilities where you could get the max and height values of a certain area of the object in. Input that data into the program that controls the positioning of the actuator. So, some other research. It's just, I wanted to get the idea of replicating the 3D printer. green process. So made robot right here. It splits it up into cubes, and so I wanted that idea of like getting the max and min values from those certain areas. And and so what I have so far, it doesn't work yet. I wasn't able to integrate it fully, but this is the actuator right here represented, connected through this linkage with the pen. And yeah.
Other questions?
Assuming you've had more time, how long do you think it would take to get it working?
So I still have to get the API work. The SOLIDWORKS API was the most trickiest part, but I feel like if I had like half a year, maybe, because I'm not as skilled in programming, if I got more help, then I'd probably be able to accomplish it.
Do you know if you were to like finish making like a whole table of these like you showed in the video, do you know around how much that would cost?
As I mentioned before, at MIT, they use a 13 by 13 shape display, so they're like, whatever how much that is, times like 100 or more, so like, it's pretty expensive.
Okay, thank you very much.